Commonwealth Studios. Joining us now is the Secretary of State of the great state of Mississippi, our good friend Michael Watson. Mr. Secretary, thanks for coming on.
Man, great to be here this morning. We're in DeSoto County. I'm in my third city already this morning, so great to get a couple minutes to chat with you.
What you traveling around for today? You visiting with the clerks and so forth?
So today is actually promote the vote. We've been in some schools this morning talking about the importance of elections and why you should be engaged. And obviously, we just had a big election last week, so great time to be in the schools talking to them about why it's important that they vote later in life.
Gosh, I hope that that is resonating with them, especially given our, let's be honest, rather poor showing in the state last week.
Yeah, we've not gotten the final numbers yet, but it's going to look like something around 35, maybe 40 at tops percent. So again, better than we saw in the primary, but unfortunately, we still need more Mississippians to get engaged, to come out and hold government accountable at the polls. And that's their voice. That's their opportunity to say, look, this country's going in the right direction or the wrong direction. We believe in what's happening in our state or not. And that's how you control and how you have a voice and a say in how our country is going to go forward here.
Do you think maybe, Mr. Secretary, it's because we didn't have maybe a higher-level headliner election on the ballots? Not saying whatsoever that voting for our House of Representative members is very important, obviously, in our republic. But we didn't have a president on the ballot, and we didn't have much other than that, right? So we had some judges, maybe some municipal as well. And I heard from just anecdotally in the Tri-County area, even with respect to the judges, a lot of those unopposed as well. So
that's
on
right.
The ballot, which may be a factor. And I just wonder if folks just think, you know, the districts as they are aligned, having just redistricted in the state of Mississippi, those are just going to go the way they're going to go. My vote is really irrelevant in the outcome.
We know it's unfortunate, Gerard. You talk about we just had congressional elections, and maybe that's why the turnout wasn't so high. But like we were talking about this morning with a bunch of eighth graders, when you look at municipal elections and understanding those are the folks that are closest to you that can have the quickest impact on your life, those turnout numbers are really low as well.
Yeah.
So it's not just that it was only congressional. I think it's just a lack of the entire population. They just aren't engaged. And it's almost like, look, I don't like politics. I don't care about politics. I'm just going to go about my own everyday life. That's why we lose control of government. When we're not engaged, when we're not holding them accountable, they tend to get comfortable. And when they get comfortable, they forget about who they serve. That's why it's important for us to be engaged and go to the polls and have our voices heard.
Yeah, that's a good point you make there, Mr. Secretary, is that how does this kind of influence the thinking of elected officials and candidates? And I think that's a great point in that you got to remember who you work for here. And when folks show up in mass in great numbers at the polls, it sends a pretty sharp reminder to them that, you know, this is a privilege to serve. And at the ballot box, it can be removed quite easily.
That's exactly
if you don't act right and you're not accountable to the people who put you there in the first place.
That's right. And look, we were in a school a couple of weeks ago in Brookhaven, Gerard, and one of the kids is a fifth grader and had a great conversation with him. And he said, hey, do our tax dollars pay your salary? And I said, you don't understand how important the question is that you just asked. Absolutely. Your tax dollars pay our salary, which means I work for you. You are the boss. You're the one that has to hold me accountable to make sure I'm doing what I told you I would do, doing my job and doing it correctly. And when we can get more people engaged and understand that idea, it's your tax dollars. I work for you. So you're the one that should be out there engaged and holding me accountable to make sure I do my job. Not only me, but every other elected official in this state and in this country.
Wow, that's refreshing that question came from an eighth grader. It's what you said, right? An eighth grader is thinking about that. How do we get more adults to ask that question?
Now, I will say this was a gifted class, and they were really, really sharp. And those are the ones that I have great, fun conversations with. Just this morning, same thing.
Yeah.
We're talking about why it's important to be engaged. What are the decisions that government makes? And look, right now, these kids are thinking about, what am I having for lunch? Is the football field going to be in good shape when I go play? And I was telling them, the decisions that are important to you now, later in life, it's going to be, do I have a good road or a bridge to get to work on? Do I have good schools for my children? Do I have good in law enforcement to keep my family safe? That's why it's important to get engaged and have your voice heard.
Yeah, that's an excellent point. I'll be honest, until 2008, I've told this story before on the air, I didn't really pay much attention to it until I saw how it might affect me in business, and that was during the campaign for president and the discussion and plans for health care reform and how that might affect me as a business owner, which it clearly has and did, right? Other than that, I kind of felt like, well, they're there, I'm here, just leave me alone, I got it. I wish that were the case, and I know you would agree with me. I think what's at the heart of this, Mr. Secretary, is that we, the people, perhaps have conferred too much power to those who govern. They got too much power. Why else would they spend $200 million in a Senate race in Pennsylvania? That's just how powerful. It shouldn't make that much of a difference. And that's the way the founders intended for it to be. And we have drifted so far away from the constitutional obligations of government. We've morphed it into so many other things. It has gotten too dang powerful. And that's why we need to be engaged to keep it in check.
But look, you know, we talk about this, the inverted pyramid that we're seeing now. When the founding fathers formed our government, you look at it like a pyramid. At the very bottom base, the most important piece of that pyramid were the people. You know, and that's how it should be. Well, unfortunately now it's been inverted, where the bottom now is the people, and it's the smallest part of the pyramid with this big federal government on top of us. That's what we've got to change. We've got to get people engaged to understand the bigger government is, the fewer decisions you get to make for yourself. That's not how it's supposed to be.
Yeah, you made another good point about how you can be directly, personally impacted by municipal elections. Look no further than the craziness that we have discovered going on in our schools in this country, and how critically important school board officials now, those that we elect to serve on our school boards, that are to a great extent deciding the content, the curriculum, and a lot of other aspects of operating the schools that are educating our children. That is incredibly important.
You think about that, there may not be any more important office in the country than school boards. That's shaping our future. The decisions that we make at our schools, how our children are educated, that's going to come home to roost. And so we've got to be engaged at that level as well.
There's no doubt about it. And we've seen a bit of a change in attitude because parents are getting more involved, showing up at these school board meetings. Not quite as extreme in Mississippi. We haven't seen quite as much radicalism occurring. At least if it's occurring, it hasn't been exposed or reported. But in some of the other areas of the country, it has, and parents are speaking up. And there's even people in the House of Representatives. I saw Representative Swalwell the other say, well, parents really shouldn't be involved in their school's education. That's tantamount to a patient being involved in the decision-making with a doctor. Well, yeah, that's how that's supposed to work. Doctors don't have free reign over your body. I mean, he just made the case for exactly what we think the way it should work, that we need to be involved.
Yeah, and look, as parents are coming to grips with, that is our God-given responsibility, our children. And their education is so important. So to have parents start to wake up and say, wait a minute, we do need to have a voice in this and how our children are educated is so incredibly important, which is one of the reasons way back when, before it got popular, I was supporting a parental choice in education. Yeah. Well, you can get parents engaged in education with the decisions for how their children are going to be raised and educated. That's when you get this country turned around. That's when it's great for children to have their parents alongside them.
We got a couple of minutes left, Mr. Secretary. You had a denial of service attack on the Secretary of State's IT systems last week. You were able to rapidly recover from that. Just real quickly, tell us about that.
Yeah, so Eric Yoakum and his team do a phenomenal job in our office. I can't thank them enough. ITS was great as well to assist us in what's going on. Just after lunch, I got a phone call that said, hey, we've seen a spike in activity. We're not sure exactly what this is yet, but the website is down. And so as reports have come out now, it was the longest sustained attack in the country, was on Mississippi. And I can't overemphasize the importance of cybersecurity and what we're doing in our office. Again, hats off to our team. They did a phenomenal job. We did have some service interruptions, but importantly, Gerard, this happened a few weeks ago. So we were prepared. We were ready to go. We told our clerks how to handle this if this happens. thank the good Lord that Mississippi was on its toes and we were ready for it.
Yeah, hats off to them. Absolutely right. You got a great team there. ITS as well participated in the recovery effort. They're good folks, know what they're doing, had a lot of experience with them. But so the point is the bad guys are out there and they're looking to do this kind of stuff to interfere with our elections. There's no doubt about it. Not to change the votes in the voting machines, to interfere with the elections process. That's the risk.
And that's very key there. Did not mess up with the election. The election was good.
Good point. Good point. We'll talk to you soon. Take care, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Good to see you. Secretary of State Michael Watson's